Hello friends, and welcome to another tutorial on Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to understand the reverse level order traversal in a binary tree. Let us begin and first understand what level order traversal in a tree means. In level order traversal, we visit each nodes at a particular depth or level before visiting the nodes at next deeper level. Let us consider this tree for example. We'll try doing a level order traversal on this one. We'll start from the first level. We print the content of this level. Notice that 1 is printed. Then we move to the next level and print its contents. 2 and 3 are printed. Then we move to the next level and 4 and 5 are printed. So this will be the final level order traversal result for this tree. In case of reverse level order traversal, we start from the last level, then go to the second last level and so on. Here the reverse level order traversal will be 4, 5, 2, 3, 1. So let's see the algorithm which will assist in achieving such a traversing scheme. These four steps will assure that we get our desired result. Note that we are using queue as well as a stack data structure. Let us also have a sample tree to test this algorithm. We begin with step 1 and create an empty queue and an empty stack. In the next step, we enqueue the root node, which is 1, in the queue. Now we check if the queue is null. Since it is not null, we enter the loop. As we enter the loop, we dequeue the node in the queue from the front and make it the root. Next, we push the root into the stack. Then we enqueue the root node's children into our queue. We push the children of 1, which are 2 and 3. Note that first the right child will be enqueued and then the left child. Since the queue is not null, we loop. Again, we dequeue the node in queue and make it the root. In our case, 3 will be dequeued. Now 3 becomes root and we push 3 into the stack. Since 3 does not have any children, nothing is enqueued in the queue. Again we check. Since queue is not null, we enter the loop. Now 2 is dequeued and pushed into the stack. Since the node 2 has 2 children, 4 and 5, we enqueue 5 and 4 into the queue. Since queue is not empty, we enter the loop. We dequeue 5 and push it into the stack. As you can see, 5 has no children, so nothing will be enqueued. Again, queue is not empty, so we enter the loop. Now 4 is dequeued and pushed into the stack. Now queue becomes empty and control will come out of the loop. In the next step, we pop each element from the stack and print. As stack is a last in first out type data structure, we pop the last element in the stack and print it. In this case, 4 is the first to be popped out and then printed. Now 5 will be popped out. In a similar way, all elements in the stack will be popped out one by one and printed. So 2, 3, 1 will be popped out and printed. As you can see, we now have the desired output. Let's look at the code implementation of our level order traversal. This will be a C++ code which is same as given on GeeksforGeeks. Note that in this code we need to implement our queue and stack data structure also, which is not shown here. Finally, let's have a look at the time complexity. This code will run in O n complexity. Here, n are the number of nodes in our tree. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. For any doubts or suggestion, please leave them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.